6 o'clock in daylight. Woke up in my clothes again from the night before. Don't really remember much of anything, just bits and pieces all mixed up in that dream. Not so sure yet which was which. My mouth's dry. Gotta take a piss. A piss.
A piss.
Put a cold clot across my eyes. Wish I could get some more sleep. Don't want to dream anymore. But I really need some more sleep. Hey, it wasn't my fault. She looked at me, walked over, introduced herself. I'm trying to stand, my liquor stunk of breath. Now here's a total stranger, no name, talking about this one desire she had. One that no one never, ever filled before. We went up the stairs, unlocked the door, into her place. She looked exactly like her chairs, used and worn by so many. But I guess hotel furniture never really care. Then I caught a frozen glance. You can sell your soul in a glimpse. One forgotten look, and forget everyone you ever knew. I understood a world racked with pain. She shed her night skins. Leather licked her flesh, releasing Catholic guilt. Silk scarves bound her to brass bedposts that never set her free. I beat her so tenderly, like a new religion being born, so ritually. Each new mark became a convert. The church spoke. She asked me. She begged me to show her how to come and die at once, to mix the blood and schism, like an unholy union between a mother and son. I took her from behind. I asked her to recite a psalm. She began to pray. The Lord is my shepherd. Through the valley of death I walk. She never even heard herself cry out. Climatic betrayal that finally set her free. The knife sliced deep within, penetrating, splitting, pumping thin, staining sheets so sacred, releasing her, just like Jesus. You have to kill me for your sins, then resurrect me, so I can kill once again, to set you free, just to set you free.